Hi everyone, this is Ellen George with Great Lakes Cisco, and I'm here at the 13th International Coragonid Symposium in Bayfield, Wisconsin. And this morning at our poster social, I'm talking with Jason Smith from the Little Traverse Bay Band of Ottawa Indians, and he is going to be talking about Lake Michigan's Cisco resurgence. So Jason, and go ahead.
So when I came here 2.5 years ago, we wanted to look at what was happening with Cisco in Lake Michigan. It was a fish that had a lot of interest, and we wanted to know what is happening with Cisco in Lake Michigan. So at that time, people knew there were Cisco here in Elk Rapids, in Grand Traverse Bay, but outside of that, people thought there were very few, if any, Cisco. And so I wondered, is that because we didn't do a good job looking for Cisco, or because there were no Cisco? So with lots of partners, tribal agencies, other state agencies, federal agencies, we tried to really increase our efforts at looking for these fish around the lake. And we found fish really everywhere we've looked. No one has actually spent much time looking in the southern half of Lake Michigan, and so we haven't found them there. So we were convinced that there's more fish than were originally thought, and so we actually had to do some of this science stuff and look at data. So this first thing that we noticed is we looked at sources of catch from many different places, assessments and fishers, a commercial catch, creel. We noticed in the late 90s, early 2000s, there's a little pulse of fish. This is the first detectable pulse of fish. Everything to this side of this figure is flatlined at zero. We didn't see fish anywhere outside of Elk Rapids. But we had this little pulse of fish. A recruitment event or two of some sort happened. We don't know the magnitude, and we don't know the mechanism that freed these fish up after 50 years of no fish. But then the next thing that we noticed was when these fish recruited to the gear, age 3 or 4 fish, we consistently, year after year, saw more. And we saw more really in every type of assessment, and even in anecdotes from many, many anglers. So I'm a believer in multiple ways of learning and knowing, and I believe that anglers and tribal fishers and commercial fishers are something that we have underutilized, and they've really informed this belief that my partners and I have about these Lake Michigan Cisco, that there are more than originally thought, they're more widespread, and that their abundance is really growing. So there's all this desire for Cisco restoration. And my argument would be that currently what we need to do is understand what's happening now. So there's interest in stocking restorations. We actually have a small stocking program with the Little Traverse Bay Bands. We just have 10 more minutes, take anywhere near that much time.
Yeah.
My argument would be that we could not currently evaluate a stocking program. We can really barely evaluate a reef program because we don't have enough baseline information yet. And so really my call to action has been, let's find out what's happening to the best of our ability and then make good management decisions. And so we have all of these tools, genetics, otolith ablation, all of these assessments. We're doing all of those currently. We don't have final results from them, but those are really key to get, maybe not to completion with all of those, but a long ways further than we are before we make big management decisions.
Great, awesome, thank you. If you have any questions, you can go ahead and type them into the comment box. Are there any questions from people around? I have one, so I liked hearing that you have also been, you talked about different ways of getting information and different ways of learning, and I feel like a lot of times us as managers forget to connect with the fishermen and the people who are out in the lake, and that's something that I've been trying to do, and several of us have been trying to do in Lake Ontario, and we found some fish last year on a tip from an ice fisherman. So do you have any advice or insights into how to connect with fishermen and how to collaborate with them productively?
So I don't know if this will be applicable to everyone,
yeah.
but we've used two methods. One, working for a tribe, we are closer to our fishermen probably than most of the other agencies. So we have a real advantage there. But the other thing that we decided, and it was as a decision, was that every time we go to the water, we talk to everyone that we see. If they don't know what a Cisco is, we tell them. If they do know what a Cisco is, we ask them when the last time they saw one. And we've really gotten amazing responses from both of those people, from people who are now interested in Cisco and from people who want to tell us what they know or what their grandparents knew about Cisco. So just it really, for us, to these other methods of learning are about talking to everyone who might know.
Great. Thank you. Any other questions around here? Okay, great. Thank you. If you have any questions, if you're watching this later after the live broadcast, you can go ahead and type them into the comments and I can relay them to Jason. Jason, thank you so much for joining us today.
You betcha.
Thanks, and we'll see all of you soon. Bye.